Food's not good.
Selfish times that we don't appreciate our life and all the beauty that
stands behind our wall. He looks in the window as he peers through the lattice. My beloved lifts up his voice. He says to me, "Come then, my loving one, come." My dove, hiding in the clefts of the rock, in the corners of the cliff, show me your face. Let me hear your voice, for your voice is sweet. Oh, and your voice and your face is beautiful. My beloved is mine, and I am his, he said to me. Set me like a seal on your heart, like a seal on your arm. For love, love is strong as death, jealousy, relentless as Sheol. The flash of it is the flash of fire, a flame of the Lord himself. Love no flood can quench, no torrent drown. This is the word of the Lord.
Responsorial Psalm. Indeed, thus shall be blessed the man who fears the Lord. Let's just say that together. Indeed, thus shall be blessed the man who fears the Lord. Oh, blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways. By the labor of your hands you shall eat. You will be happy and prosper. Say, indeed, thus shall be blessed the man who fears the Lord. Your wife will be like a fruitful vine in the heart of your house, your children like shoots of the olive around your table. Indeed, thus shall be blessed the man who fears the Lord. Indeed, thus shall be blessed the man who fears the Lord. May the Lord bless you from Zion all the days of your life. Indeed, thus shall be blessed a man who fears the Lord. We'll have our second reading now.
A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. Be ambitious for the higher gifts, and I am going to show you a way that is better than any of them. If I have all the eloquence of a man or of angels, but speak without love, I am simply a gong, booming, or cymbal clashing. If I have the gift of prophecy, understanding all the mysteries there are, and knowing everything, and if I have faith in all its fullness to move mountains, but without love, then I am nothing at all. If I give away all that I possess, piece by piece, and if I even let them take my body to burn it, but am without love, it will do me no good, whatever. Love is always patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offense and is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's sins, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. Love does not come to an end. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you."
There were six stone jars standing there. Each could hold 20 or 30 gallons. And Jesus said to the servants, "Fill the jars with water." And they filled them to the brim. "Draw some out now," he told them, "and take it to the steward." They did this, and the steward tasted the water, and it had turned into wine. Having no idea where it came from, only the servants who had drawn the water knew, the steward called the bridegroom and said, "People generally serve the best wine first and keep the cheaper sort till the guests have had plenty to drink. But you have kept the best wine until now." This was the first of the signs given by Jesus. It was given at Cana in Galilee. He let his glory be seen, and his disciples believed in him. And this is Jesus' word. Thanks to God. Please be seated.
Today, I think that reading I just read to you from the Feast of the Wedding, the Feast of Cana. You know, it fits into a lot of marriages, that gospel I read to you. Let me explain. Anytime you read the scriptures, it's always good to have history. Always good to know about the culture of those people and why it was written at that time. If in the Jewish culture of Jesus' time, when a man and woman were to get married, it was a whole week party. You wouldn't have it easy, you guys. A whole week of celebration, of feasting. Also, they would have given the message out in the town and told the people a year ago that they were getting married, but they would never tell the people what day or what time. And so they'd always say that you had to be ready. You don't know when the bridegroom is coming. That's what our Lord says when before you die. You don't know when he's coming. When he gets you, the moment you least expect. A wedding feast is a great time. You know, they compare a wedding to what heaven is going to be like. You go to the Bible and read, always referring to heaven as a wedding. As we know that little background, what happened today? And I think sometimes we get the idea of Jesus that, you know, Jesus is holy and all this stuff and we admire him. But he probably didn't have any fun. Jesus had a tremendous sense of humor. First of all, he does. Second of all, it shows today he goes to a wedding. They had wine. There must have been dancing. If you know the Jewish culture, there'd be lots of dancing. And who was invited to the wedding? His mother, Mary, the disciples. And every time you read about Jesus, he's usually doing some work for somebody or helping somebody. And today he's at a party. What happens at the party that's very interesting is, again, you go back to the culture. If you were to run out
prayers as you minister. Lord, hear our prayer. For Jeff and Tamara, whose marriage we are celebrating, that they know the presence of Christ and his mother in their married life, so that they may be able to change the water of selfishness into the wine of pure love, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all married couples, especially those here present, that Christ may help them to persevere when they experience their own and their partner's poverty. must be eternal life to receive. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father, the work of the Holy Spirit, in your death brought life to the world. By your holy body, blood, free us from all our sins and every evil. Keep us faithful to your teachings. Never let us depart from them. This is Jesus, our Lord, who takes away the sin of the world. Have
Don't lose your teddy bear.
Mark, stay back.
Sarah. Here, Sarah, I'll show you how to do it.
Okay, down in the way. Trudy, over here, buddy.
Oh.
Yo. Mommy, can you save the bubbles?
Sure.
Pictures in here.
Perfect.
That's okay. It'll dry.
Can I take the teddy bear and save it for you? Where's your teddy bear, Trina?
My eyes are going off.
Here, Trina, you want to do it over here?
I never do this.
I got some.
Huh?
Oh, you shot him, Mommy.
Geez, she's got the big one.
Trina, come here once. I'll daddy show you.
Yeah, Megan's here.
She's like. Well, I gotta go. Congratulations.
Hey now.
Now you feel some balls
off. Yeah, you were fantastic.
Thank you very much. There goes.
It has, actually.
Okay, you need one. Here.
Oh, I got it. So, Karen, you lost one.
Mammy, these are your flowers. Here, there's another one for you.
Rick,
give your daughter her
something. What?
Let Brianna blow those. I can't get this open.
Here, Brianna. Here's some levels for you. Okay, I'll hold this. I'll hold your beer. Okay, I'll hold on. You blow bubbles.
Here. Where's the other one?
That's Sammy.
Where's Trina's? Where's Poppy has it?
Wow, there's a big bubble.
Is there one more?
Sure. Okay.
Perfect.
Go tell Rachel.
Rachel.
Papa.
Wait, I give it to you.
Yeah, yeah. What's that? I got your bubbles. I was worried about your flowers. You have got pictures yet.
Show me tell you about how I got down here. I had no idea who I was driving.
Here,
like, took the time to figure out. So bad. No, somebody like totally that. Actually, they were going somewhere else. They're like,
I hope he.
Bad bubble.
Who's that bass is down?
Bass is
Ham. Richie.
I think I got it.
The two of you ride the buggy.
Yeah, by the park there.
Yeah.
Right. Bit. Okay.
I am just starving. I haven't eaten anything all day. I haven't eaten anything yet.
Wave, you guys. Get the wave down.
Oh, Brianna's not happy.
She's not.
There's all girls on there.
I love
her.
Oh,
yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
What is? Some people know that I'm filming.
No.
I can get most of them on.
I don't know.
Good shot. Of course. Let's go.
Mark?
Look at Eric, he's all set up.
What, right behind you. Oh, cool.
Now we'll watch the drill.
Yeah, that was very good.
That was good.
Yeah.
I was impressed. Yeah, I liked it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I could be rich if I had to make some of these things.
Yeah.
Oh, watch out behind you.
Oh, they don't get
sure you've seen it.
Yeah, that's a good thing. Mark, you pointed out.
Oh, yeah, I need a cheeseburger, fries, anything, I don't care. Hot dog, piece of bread.
A little cracker. Trina Bird. You're pulling these big tight again.
Bread and water.
Get this.
What happened? Okay, I'm going to try to set up over on the other side. Yeah. They're going to get a lot of shaky stuff. She moved on me.
I know. No. Yeah.
You sure you're gonna be okay, Tamara?
She'd like to punch me right now.
You did a very good job on the reading. Sorry. Brian was just laughing. She was laughing so hard.
You're gonna die when you see this on video.
You cannot wait to see it on video.
I don't want to see
it. His voice is just going up and he's trying to put it like, oh my god.
I can't believe that you can just be faithful.
I tell you, I had to put my hand over my mouth.
I wanted to laugh a few times.
I had my hand over my mouth.
I wanted to laugh at myself. I thought I was funny.
Oh my god.
Oh yeah.
I'm sorry. Okay.
Hey, we'll see you in Shakopee.
Yay!
On the 19th.
Keep on going.
I missed that.
Bye, Sam.
Yeah, hey.
Cheaty. Oh, I have to be careful. Stay down there, Tooties.
Trina. Come here a minute. Let me tie you in the hair.
No, the pictures of the
back. Honey, you just go look at the dessert.
Trina! I'm gonna go back down.
Okay.
Trying to read.
Just slowly taking pictures. Did you want to say anything?
Cheers. Nostrovia.
We're still into the wine rocks. We're not worrying about the water.
Yeah, we're not into the water.
Yeah. The water's a long ways. Maybe tomorrow when the bills come in.
Yeah, then the water is. Oh, yeah. The reality.
So you going to dance today? Are you going to sing some songs?
You didn't sing Bad Boy a song. They called him Bad Boy because he took candy.
Who's Bad Boy?
Jeff.
Oh.
Jeff is bad boy.
Oh, you got a nice necklace. And what is it? Is that your boyfriend in there?
Is there anything nice?
Like what?
You don't know anything nice.
Classic Eric.
The only thing I know about him is that she's been a pain in the butt all her life.
There you are.
It's a good thing she found somebody.
No.
Wait, okay, what?
I was just going to say, we love you, Tam.
That's it?
Just congratulations. We've had a wonderful time.
Yeah, yeah.
The best wishes to both of you, and if you ever get sick of Jeff, you just come stay with me.
She might take you up on that when the honeymoon's over. When the wine runs out.
Oh, the wine runs out.
Yeah. It's happened where we've pieces. Been just a few minutes of those two getting into trouble.
Here we go. It's recording, Father. Just think
Tamara,
of one.
Welcome to the family. You're too beautiful for us, but we're glad to have you. The wine runs out. Remember, we're there to help you. Love you.
Oh, Jeff, I forgot to say something to you, too. Looks like you guys are a real nice family. Looks like both of you guys are going to be merging a great unit.
Gordy, would you like to say anything?
The Stack family is going to be a great addition to the McCormick clan. Just looking at the numbers there, Saturday. Well, we're 19 and you're probably about 13.
Okay, just a second. Go.
All right, Jeff, we're just curious about whatever happened with that conversation we had with your boss in Greece that one evening. We're just curious. Anyhow, we want to wish you the best, you and Tamara. And you guys deserve each other. Great happiness. And what do you guys think?
Got it all covered.
Yeah, I'll just get your profile, though.
Oh, well, thank you.
I'll just say something, Kale.
What do you want me to say? You're cute?
Next time, send us the good stuff.
Just wait, just wait.
Next time, send us the good stuff, would you?
Okay, just stand there.
Congratulations, though, Tamara and Jeff. Best of luck.
You then. Okay, go.
Hey, Jeff and Tamara, congratulations. Jeff,
say hey.
Favorite little nephew, you take care of yourself.
Oh, yeah. Take care of Tamara. Jeff and Tamara, may you have a life of many much happiness, lots of fun, and never go to bed.
Oh, yeah, I mean, it's a little
now, working out.
Psychologist.
And talk love.
It was a very lovely wedding. We enjoyed it. Really glad to have Tamara in with my family.
Anything you want to say?
Well, I just would like to wish Jeff and Tamara all the best. Thank you very much.
Anything I want to say? Yes. Hello, welcome to our family.
He's speechless.
Is it the wife?
A wonderful life. Dad is always right.
Mom?
Mom is always right.
Never stop and ask for directions. Never say you're wrong. Say oops once in a while.
Yeah, where are you from?
Not
to mesh. It's hard to say, but the Yanks kicked our ass today. That's $9.
And wish him a happy life.
You betcha.
We'll have another drink on his wedding. Good one. Have fun. What this? Yeah. Come.
Okay, I'm ready. Watch babies to make sure that all girls get their best. Okay. 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 Make sure that boys get their best.
little bit louder.
And I'd like to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Jeff and Tamara McCormick. So maybe this would be a good time just to ask God to bless us all. The food tonight, we're going to eat and burp. So we need to thank God. What a wonderful gift of that food, let me tell you. So we ask God to bless the food and bless them with a very happy marriage together. And ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Thank you for having me. your best man. At least something I'll remember always. And I want everybody to raise their glass and to toast to the groom. Years of college,
and many dollars, as Dad would tell you. And I think we all kind of got in the round table and said, what is she, crazy? You know, pay off some bills.
Rick's an accountant, by the way.
How boring being done, you know. Hey. She used that strong will to fight us off, and little did we know it would be the most important trip of her life, because that's where she met Jeff, of course. So, you know, I guess I have a strong-willed wife, too, and sometimes I wish she didn't have that strong will, but that's something you can't use, Jeff, because without it, you wouldn't have met her. She can tell you that. Well, with that said, I'd like to welcome you to the Static family, Jeff. We look forward to spending time with you at the holidays and the get-togethers. Obviously, with the distance, we won't have as much quantity time, but we'll rely on quality time, and we look forward to that. So, if everybody raised their glass, I've lost it already. Jeff, welcome to the family. May this marriage last forever.
All right. Yeah, I'm already drinking water over here.
I'm long-winded, but I'm done.
Evening, folks. I read a few things now, but Kathy's the talker in the family, but I'm going to say my congratulations and welcome everybody. I've written a few things down, so you have to bear with me. I may have to read a bit. First of all, Tamara and Jeff, I would like to congratulate you. Great day. We'll go through Jeff and Tamara and my family and welcome the Stack family. And Jeff, first of all, makes me very proud as a dad to see you picked the same day I made my vows with my dear wife. And the second thing is to bring Tamara into our life. It's the day you introduced her to us. She's been a daughter we've never had. So as far as Kathy probably would also say that, we'll be there for you from this day on. Thank you. Father Vince here has made it very, very special for Kathy and I and Jeff and Tamara. This date, August 22nd, we did Father Vince, Tamara, I think, gave him three dates, and coincidental that August 22nd was picked for his schedule, and I don't think Tamara knew it was our anniversary, but it was just coincidental, so... But Father Vince, this is something very special to have you here. The McCormick clan, led by my mom and 19 strong, we're all here. And we're a very close-knit family, and thank you for being here. And we really appreciate that. Stack family.
You can't go.
We can beat all of you, I tell you.
The Stack family, all we can say is thank you very much for Tamara. We'll take excellent care of her. And our home is your home, and like I say, we're gonna be just increased our families. I mean, like everybody said though, that I think McCormick clan is going to have to work a little on their golfing because the Stack family's hands on that. Thank you very much. Enjoy the evening. And,
actually, Gordon said almost everything that I want to say, but I just have to tell you this little story. I'm really sorry I couldn't find it in
my wonderful clean house. I put it away somewhere for this day and it's disappeared. However, I just, as I was cleaning up this wonderful house of mine, I found this letter that Jeff had written shortly after he met Tamara over in Greece. And do you want to leave now, Jeff? And it went on saying, I have just met this girl and she's from Minnesota and isn't she wonderful and so on and so forth. And at the very bottom of all this, it said, there's only one thing that really scares me about her. She's just the type of girl you'd pick for me. And he's right. Welcome to the family, Tamara. You've been ours since you came here.
Special to me because I was very close with my grandma and to have Father Vince with us today. It means a great deal to me. I consider this, I feel like I'm the luckiest man in the world to have what happened to me happen today. And the booze is on Gordy, so I hope you have a good time. Thank you.
Psychology in it.
Is it? Yeah, it must be.
You could kiss again. No food in your teeth, Jeff. One more time, kiss. Come on, stand up and kiss for me.
Yeah.
meant the smile.
Thank you. I'm enjoying you saw, Trina? Even the relatives are coming to the wedding.
Hold on, girls.
You know what? It should be here by now, any minute. Outside, waiting for the carriage. Girlie, sing Bad Boy.
Bad Boy, what you gonna do?
What you gonna do? How's the rest go, Sam? Really loud.
Bad Boy, Bad Boy, what you gonna do? I'm gonna fly, I'm gonna watch. What you gonna do?
Take care of you with Trina. Wave. Jeff is. He's just out relaxing with a friend.
My brother is.
He'll be down soon. Keep dancing.
But I didn't.
Friends came to see if they could come to the wedding reception. We said they had to stay outside. Samantha, tell me that again. What did you say?
Later,
it's a nice.
Later can they smile?
Thank you. good. Jeff, I'm going to move to Lac Le Pouche. Saying that to me. Oh, Davey, I do.
Jeff, suck in your gut.
Did they make that as a whole show?
Yeah. Oh my God, that's a huge piece. Swallow, Tam, swallow.
You didn't get it every good.
Yeah, Jeff.
What a sport, what a sport.
No,
I was gonna say,
Mike. bartender who is very polite. What you gonna have there, Gord? I'm not purposely getting you on. I'm just getting Tamara's office. Wave, Tammy. Come on now, wave. There you go. You got the sign.
Bad boy.
Bad boy.
What
they
you gonna do?
Bad boy when Tammy left with him. They didn't like him because he took Tammy away. Bad boy.
Sammy, don't hang on Mom's purse.
Bad boy, what you gonna do?
When they come for you. Did he buy a hat? Bruce in Pitcher's Creek wearing and sporting a new hat. Okay, Sam, your part. We lost you. We were looking for you.
What did you want?
Okay. I didn't put money in there. Some guy gave it to me. Trina, what did you see?
I want to show you some cool rocks.
Excuse me. Tammy, why don't you go stand over by Bad Boy?
Yeah, stand by Bad Boy. Get over there.
What you gonna do?
She said Sam, not Tammy. I thought she said Tammy.
I said Tammy.
Yeah, here we are at Frank's Slide. It's not that great.
Anything else? How many people died here? How many people died in 1903?
70, yeah, 70.
Crushed.
Came down on their village.
That one over there said the cause.
Is this the one that happened?
He said the main cause was the geological foundation of the mountain, the mining that they were doing inside, and the water going into the cracks and the freezing.
Mommy?
We'll see it, Trina. Trina wants to go inside to see a little rock that costs money. And now she's all bent out of shape because we haven't gone inside to look at the rock yet. But we will in time if she only gives it time. Just not so fast, honey. There's the walkway.
You got the keys to the car?
Oh, it's nice.
What is it?
Cold.
Whoa!
There's that Bad Boy Jeff again. Mr. Tormentor, that's going to be his next nickname.
We were here one day, one Saturday, cold, and it was so hot. This was crowded, like there were a million people. There is someone in there somewhere.
This would be nice to own by yourself. Yeah. With the restriction. There's a lot of fish. There's about 3 feet here.
Right? Yeah.
It's stocked.
From
what kind? Trout and whitefish. It's stocked from our pasture. Just little ones, though. They don't take much to do.
I can't get the trout.
Now there is a true die-hard Canadian.
It's pretty, isn't it?
I can't get my shirt.
I'm so cold, my back.
Now this is Chinook Lake. Is he always this crazy?
Yeah. Are you freezing? Oh my god, are you freezing?
Feel the water, it's like ice water.
Oh my gosh.
Now that would be totally invigorating.
You should see this like on a hot day though. It's just insane. Oh, there's a picture.
That is Crow Mountain. Crow's Nest Mountain.
Oh, Sam, did you throw a rock in there? Isn't this a cute
Dad,
we're going to the car.
Can you pick the flowers?
Anything else you want to say, Tammy?
Here. No.
Points of interest?
Yeah. Chinook Lake.
What's the name of this lake?
The big cute little lake.
Chinook Lake?
Chinook Lake.
What?
Can you pick the flowers? Warm winds.
Yeah. No, you cannot pick the flowers. Why not?
Thank you.
Mommy, can you climb up the stripes?
I'm watching.
I have a little candle to go with it.
Sam, you're natural.
Put your fingers in.
Look at Sammy. You're natural, Sam.
Get real deep, or is it just a little bit? You walked around, you can get up higher, see right down. You can see the fish.
What?
so clear, isn't it? It's so pristine.
They're climbing a mountain.
God. Get exercise, Sam. Nice spread. Okay, jump up and down. I'm having a hard time keeping this thing.
Isn't that pretty? See that mountain up there?
Bless you.
Keep that on your head. I think I'd have it up right about in here. And I'd have maybe 6 guest cabins further down.
That Jeff is a pest.
Sam's so sad.
Watching Peter Pan. Have I taken a picture of your apartment yet, Tam? I don't think I have. Yeah. Zoom in on the picture. Grandma May, left-handed, after a stroke.
The ship's bewitched.
Your name, Freddy?
No, Splash, Captain.
Sir, you want to splash, Mr. Stark.
I do.
Oh,
the new coffee pot that Bruce and Sharon bought Jeff and Tammy for their apartment. The booze we bought at the duty-free shop before we entered Canada. $11 for that Southern Comfort. What we enjoyed doing when coming to Canada. Watching Peter Pan. Hi, Jack. Jump up and down. A little boy. Where's that little boy?
Okay, we're gone.
There's Jack.
Let's go.
Zoom in on those suckers.
Oh, I think they can run fast if they want to.
What is this park called?
Waterton, but we're not in it yet.
We're not in Waterton yet, just on the outskirts of Waterton, which is connected with the Montana
Glacier
National Park.
What's the matter with you here? Sit down. They're not going to get you. You're just like a big cow. Yep, just a big cow. They sell buffalo burgers in the store.
There he is. This is a coyote. paper.
That your dad bought him a Christmas.
Look really close, there's
that's
a bear.
That's a black bear. They're much
smaller. Oh, this one is a what?
A black bear.
Oh, a black bear.
Grizzlies are humane.
I thought the last one was okay.
Okay, we've seen the bear.
Yeah. Now he's coming. See him? See him here?
Oh. Here he comes.
See him moving there?
I can't see it.
Huh?
Oh, Jeff, we gotta lift her up again.
Go over by Jeff, honey, and watch out for the cars.
Here, Jeff, lift you up again.
No.
Yeah, you want to see him?
I can see him.
No. Right there.
I see him now.
Oh, I got a good shot of his little mouth. You can? Waterton National Park, downtown. This is a city that people do live in.
Remember George Costanza with the billfold deal?
With the big fat billfold from all your receipts?
Repeat that, Bruce. What was that?
George
Show us.
Costanza's billfold.
Show us your billfold.
Remember that?
With all the receipts?
Sugar and a little vinegar in there.
Okay. Trina, what'd you order for lunch? Are you gonna eat it? This is where we had lunch, an Italian. I'll just give it to Sarah. What did you order?
I told her that I want.
The view outside the restaurant, sitting here as I wait for my lunch, steak sandwich.
Big boy, he's in the shade, huh?
Hey. Just stay there, I gotta take a picture of you. Sing a song or something.
Sing the Canada song.
No.
No. Fun, yeah.
What one?
Bicycle.
Yeah, one. I want to go.
No, get for me. Hello, honey buddy. Maybe we'll have fun on those.
You want to go on there?
Why, sure.
Mommy, don't be on there.
Do you think so?
Thank you.
in your pocket, honey. You don't want to throw your pretty, pretty ones in there. What's inside your shoe?
Cookies.
You have something inside your shoe?
Yeah, my shoes are.
Put them on your finger, Trin. Get under its legs. He's not gonna bite ya. He went away. There he is. Came back.
Where? Mommy, here's one.
Yeah. What is this called?
It's called Cameron Falls. The town site of Waterton.
Cameron Falls, one of the massive folds in the ancient 600 million year old rocks exposed in this park, has become visible through the erosional action of the waterfall. The rocks so exposed are of the Waterton Formation and constitute the oldest rocks observed anywhere in the park, in this part of the Rocky Mountains.
And there is a rock to show you how old.
Same way we are.
He's taking the boat ride too.
Oh. Once your body gets used to it.
Don't drop it down there.
Oh, would you throw my fan up out of the way? He wants to go on the small boat.
No, he can't see that good out of that one.
But like he's standing down there by the small boat. Yeah, pretty soon, whenever they get ready.
Look at the scene. Look at mommy's windows.
You don't have that back and forth motion you kind of feel right now, but you won't feel that here for another minute or two. But typically the wind's either right on or behind us. And the shipwright who built this boat built it on the lines of a large canoe. Notice it's long and it's narrow. Typically about 73 feet long, only about 16 feet wide if it's beam and its width. Typically a ship of this length would have it twice the width or the beam that it has at 16 feet, closer to 25 to 30 feet. But because the shipwright built it specifically for this lake, the winds that it would encounter, and for its purpose, just to bring people up and down the lake, built it again on the lines of a large canoe. Came up here and noticed, saw how the winds blew typically around here. I should also tell you now that we're away from the dock, well away from the dock anyway, that this boat, the International, is 71 years old this summer. It's an all-wooden vessel. 71 years. But it only works 3 months every year. So can you imagine if you were 71 and only had to work 3 months every year, how cold you would feel? So, British, Canadian kind of expedition that came through in the early 1870s. A little bit farther down, we'll talk about some of the other peaks down there. But those particular names,
Citadel,
I guess, kind of hear every day. But just to give you some idea of some of the history of the area, how the names attributed to some of these mountain peaks.
Glacier National Park.
Probably should have named it Glacier National Park.
Site.
The landscape that you see around us, particularly like Citadel Peaks, has that narrow ridge. And all the mountains you see around us in the valleys, this is all due to glaciation. And that's why Glacier National Park is its name. It's a landscape that's been recently glaciated. Not
glaciated.
Because of the glaciers that are in this
Glacier National Park.
Glacier National
Park is glaciated.
There's no glaciers left in waters and lakes now.
Daddy.
On the camera.
Just say hi in the camera. Hi, Daddy.
Hi, Daddy.
We'll show him what he's missing.
No.
Sing him your song. Why not? I think you should sing it when Tammy is walking down the aisle. Mm-hmm. You're already down there and you can't sing.
Mountain Valley. You see a mountain up there that kind of fills the valley at the very end. That's Mount Custer. If you drive up to Cameron Lake and look down to the end of Cameron Lake, that's the mountain you see. You'll see Mount Custer, and you'll see those three patches of snow up near the top of Mount Custer. The larger area of snow down about halfway down on Mount Custer, that's...
Just a second. They're just playing. They're not fighting. This is normal. See, we have it pretty good at home. Just a second, Sam. Not yet. Move, Sammy.